Let's begin with CNN's Nick Valencia. He's live at the courthouse in Atlanta. Rudy Giuliani is still in there. You caught up with him. You spoke with him on the way in. What did he say?
Yeah, Kate, he was defiant and exuding confidence on his way in to testify. This is a significant moment. If you remember, he was expected to testify last week before his attorneys filed a late emergency motion asking for a continuance because of health concerns. Ultimately, a Fulton County judge asked him to appear today, giving him plenty of time, he said, to get here by alternative methods. And on his way into court, I was able to pepper him with some questions, including asking him whether or not he lied before Georgia lawmakers when he spoke to them at least three times. He spoke to them three times, I should say, in the wake of the 2020 election. Mr. Giuliani, when you met with Georgia lawmakers, did you lie to them?
We will not talk about this until it's over. It's a grand jury, and grand juries, as I recall, a secret.
Do you believe President Trump is the ultimate target of this investigation?
I'm not going to comment on the grand jury investigation.
What do you think their ultimate goal is here?
More about it.
What are you expecting to talk about here today?
Well, they asked the questions, and we'll see.
Will you be cooperative? I mean, your attorney in New York says you can't promise how responsive you'll be.
Yeah, Mayor Giuliani.
Just to remind us, it was Giuliani that spoke before those Georgia lawmakers three times in the wake of the 2020 election to spread conspiracy theories and baseless claims of voter fraud, claims that have since been proven to be untrue. But ultimately, he is here on a judge's orders. How cooperative he'll be to those questions from the special purpose grand jury, that's the big question. His attorney, Bob Costello, in New York, indicating that the DA is playing hardball, and they know how to play hardball, too.
Joining me right now, CNN legal analyst and former federal prosecutor Jennifer Rogers and CNN national security analyst Juliette Kayyem. She's a former assistant secretary for the Department of Homeland Security. Jennifer, let's talk about, talk to me first about Rudy Giuliani. What does today mean for Rudy Giuliani?
Well, of course, we now know that he's a target of the investigation, Kate, which I think means he's going to plead the fifth and not actually testify today. In fact, he'd be foolish to do so. They're asking him questions in an investigation that they've already told him he may be indicted in. So that's not to say that he shouldn't cooperate, but that would be a different process where his lawyers would contact the DA's office and set up a different meeting. But I think he's not going to go into the grand jury and actually answer their questions because their questions are about his possible criminal culpability in this investigation. So I suspect he won't give them much today.
At the risk of sounding, asking the obvious, Jennifer, the reason why you would think he should plead the fifth is because, well, everything he's saying in there could be directly related to what could get him in trouble.
That's right. I mean, a witness always knows kind of whether they've done something that they don't want to disclose. But in this case, he's been told by the DA that she knows, too. And so that suggests that for sure he should take the fifth and not testify today.
Juliette, how valuable do you think Giuliani is to investigators?
Oh, he's exceptionally valuable because this case, I've always called the sleeper case, the fake electors case. It's sort of like the opening scene of Jaws. It sort of slowly begins to become a big deal and a threat, I think, to the planning around undermining the election, because this part, the fake electors, and the consistency amongst all the different states, Georgia just is the focus right now, but there's a numerous states in which it was the same exact language, people signing it, was intended or only would have worked if there wasn't certification on January 6th. So why wouldn't there be certification? Possibly because there was an insurrection or violence and they were unable to meet. So I think the ties between the fake electors, which looks like a legal issue, really does get to the strategy behind how would it have worked. So I think he's very important. I agree with Jennifer, as always, you know, he's not going to speak, but he did seem a little bit less, I want to put words into his mouth, but he's there. And he is not ignoring this subpoena.